Recent media reports have drawn attention to the issue of contaminated water at the Fukushima Daiichi nuclear power plant of the Tokyo Electric Power Company, Tepco. At the site, strenuous efforts toward decommissioning are being made. In order to store the 400 tons of contaminated water being generated every day, Tepco is under great pressure to build a huge number of additional tanks, conduct maintenance, and patrol the site. What is this contaminated water? What can be done with the increasing volume of it? Focusing on the contaminated water issue, JaifTV looks for a solution. At the Fukushima Daiichi site, systems to cool the reactors have been completed, and 400 tons of water are circulated every day. The origin of the contaminated water is the great amount of seawater that flowed into the reactor buildings as a result of tsunamis. Some 75,000 tons of water has accumulated in the buildings, contaminated water bearing radioactive materials. This accumulated water is pumped up. Debris, cesium, etc., and salt are removed, and that water is then circulated to cool the reactors at a rate of 400 tons per day. In addition, groundwater flows into the buildings through gaps for piping and cables in the basements. About 800 to 1,000 tons of groundwater is thought to flow daily from the mountainside to the oceanside, with perhaps 400 tons of it entering the buildings. In all, 800 tons of water is pumped up from the buildings and purified, and half of that, 400 tons, is used to cool the reactors. The other 400 tons have been stored in tanks that have been built one after another at the site. Simple arithmetic says more tanks will continue to be needed. What is in the contaminated water stored in the tanks? Media reports frequently mention cesium-137, strontium-90, and tritium as problems. But cesium-137 is almost totally removed by purification equipment used as part of the cooling loops. In addition to water flowing into the buildings, groundwater and rainwater passing through the station premises pick up various contaminants and continue to the sea. Many radioactive materials reached the sea immediately after the accident, but then mixed with seawater and were quite diluted outside the Fukushima Daiichi port area. Marine environmental experts who have been monitoring the sea area off the Fukushima Daiichi for many years dispute serious environmental effects from this water, based on levels and effects of atomic bomb testing in the early 1960s.
The concentration of cesium-137 rose sharply immediately after the accident and reached 200 becquerels per liter in mid-April. This was the highest level of cesium-137 outside the 30-kilometer sphere. But mixed with ordinary seawater in the open sea, the 200 becquerels per liter concentration fell quickly and was only 1 becquerel per liter 6 months later. Data this past August showed it to be 0.01 becquerels per liter. Given a level of 0.001 to 0.002 becquerels per liter before the accident, it can be said that the value is again very close to the pre-accident level. The level now is approximately that of the 1970s.
The current value of cesium-137, measured 30 kilometers off Fukushima, is 0.01 becquerels per liter. The World Health Organization, WHO, sets a cesium-137 standard for drinking water at 10 becquerels per liter. The current measured value is very low. The situation is similar for strontium-90.
Right now, the value of strontium-90 is a bit higher than before the accident, but is better, lower, than the level of cesium. I can say the concentration is returning to the level before the accident. Already, Currently, it is very low, and I don't see a problem.
Installation of multi-nuclide removal equipment, advanced liquid processing system, ALPS, in a cooling loop can fully remove 62 kinds of radioactive materials, including the tiny amounts of cesium and strontium-90 that had not been removed previously. Everything except tritium. Tritium is the only radioactive material that cannot be removed by ALPS. Many people are not familiar with tritium. It is an isotope of hydrogen and, technologically, it is extremely difficult to separate it from water. In very tiny amounts, it is present in tap water.
It may not be commonly known that tritium is created in nature and has existed on Earth from the very beginning. Cosmic rays from the sun strike atoms in the air, producing tritium, which circulates from the stratosphere into our world. Additionally, the level of tritium rose sharply by a factor of 100 as a result of all the atomic bomb testing in the 1960s. Tritium has a half-life of 12 years, so the level has been declining steadily since then. The after-effects of those tests are now close to zero, but the level of tritium will never be zero. Tritium will always be produced by nature. We will always be able to detect it. There is nothing unusual about this.
Ordinary nuclear facilities also release tritium after diluting and measuring its concentration, and they monitor it. Japan Nuclear Fuel Limited sets a target of 18,000 terabecquerels per year released from its reprocessing facility. In the past, a maximum of 1,300 terabecquerels per year was released into the sea. Currently, 1,800 terabecquerels of tritium are estimated to be accumulated at the Fukushima Daiichi. Globally, 1,275,000 terabecquerels of tritium are in circulation. Many countries discharge tritium to the sea. The UK releases the most. The Sellafield site is located in the northern part of England. It was a pioneer in nuclear research, including for military use. At present, it is a leader in the area of decommissioning. It is also active in the reprocessing of spent fuel and in the management of radioactive waste.
We discharge tritium via two routes at Sellafield, one to the air and other to the marine environment. We have an authorization for our discharges, and for the marine environment, we are at about 5 to 10% of our authorized limit. That varies with the amount of processing we do here at Sellafield. And that is in the range of 1,000 to 2,100 terabecquerels per year, with an authorized limit of 20,000 terabecquerels. And our day-to-day performance of our operations here at Sellafield has such a low impact on the environment.
Tritium is particularly interesting in an environmental context because it doesn't accumulate in body tissues. And that's why discharge limits for tritium can be higher. And why I wouldn't be particularly worrying about it. So the purpose of the regulatory limit is to ensure that the discharges cause no harm to people or the environment. And so almost by construction, if the discharges are below that regulatory limit, then they cause no environmental they have no environmental impact and they cause no harm to people or the environment.
How should the Fukushima Daiichi site handle water with tritium?
I think it's important to deal with the water. I think it has become a too big problem, and I think at the site you need to concentrate on taking care of the waste, the spent fuel and other components, and the water should not be allowed to be building up more and more on the site and causing more and more problem. And as I have learned that the measurements show that the levels are such that they could be discharged to the sea. I think. Otherwise, there will be more problems on the site if the water cannot be discharged. More problems for the people working on the site, as well as storing things in tanks are not a solution, because it's growing more and more tanks every day, and it will be hard to look after.
So I think if we mean the water that's been through the treatment process through Alps and whatever replaces Alps, so that it is water just containing tritium, then ultimately, in my opinion, probably the best place for that water is to be discharged. And discharges within that regulatory limit have no additional effect on people or the environment.
I think the regulatory limit that is set is something that is possible to use in this case, and if that is used and the water is discharged, there will be no impact, because the levels are low, and as soon as it comes to sea, the levels will be even lower, and there is tritium already in nature, and these levels are comparable to those levels. Of course, in the tank there is more, but as soon as you start to dilute it, it will be of no impact to health for people.
The Japanese government and Tepco plan to build additional tanks, seeming to believe it is taboo to release tritium into the sea. Scientists and experts, however, recognize that the obvious solution is to dilute the tritium and release it. Monitoring would be undertaken with the participation of specialized international agencies. The results would be open to the public. In this way, international understanding could be obtained, and the tritium could be discharged. Continuing to build tanks, storing the water forever, ignores science and reason, and it's a waste of labor and money. Judgment should be cool, rational, and based on facts, not on exaggerated and unfounded fears of radioactive materials.